Chapter 8 of Matthew begins with Jesus doing, well, what no other religious leader of his day was willing to do. He touches, he heals a leper, an outcast, what is known at that time as really an untouchable. And then it shifts and he heals a Roman soldier's servant. Then he touches Peter's mother-in-law and heals her of a fever. And then next, listen to what happens as the news begins to spread. When evening had come, they brought to him many who were demon-possessed, and he cast out the spirits with a word and healed all who were sick, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, "He himself took our infirmities and bore our sickness." After this, one of the most dramatic things for the disciples occurs. There's a big storm on the Sea of Galilee. Jesus is asleep in the boat, and he speaks, and he stops the wind, and he stops the waves. The men marvel, saying, "Who can this be that even the wind and the waves obey him?" See, here's the deal. They had seen him as a teacher, a healer, a miracle worker. Now they see him as one who has power over nature. So the question is, who is this in the boat with us? And that's the issue. He's so much more than ever they imagined. They had seen him as a teacher, a healer, a miracle worker. Now they see him as one who has power even over nature. And the question is, who is this in the boat with us? And that's a question for us. Who are we in the boat with? Jesus is so much more than we ever imagined him to be. And right after that, he stills this physical storm, of course. Then he goes ashore in the last part of the chapter and cast out demons and some men from the Gadarene. He now heals a spiritual storm. So here's the question. Who are we in the boat with? Jesus, who's Lord over all. He heals physically, he heals spiritually, and he even has power over nature. And Matthew chapter 8 reveals this in a powerful way, that we are in the boat with Jesus, Lord over all.